Let's say you get pushed out of a spacecraft or in outer space, but you don't have a spacesuit on. Your gut instinct, you're going to hold your breath. But that's the wrong thing to do, because actually, you should exhale. And the reason is, there's a quick shift in the air pressure. It's actually going to suck out all the air inside your lungs and your sinus and your ears. Pretty painful. So then you're going to get dizzy and nauseous. And actually, it'll force a bowel movement. But you're really not thinking about that at this point, right? Because the liquids in your tissues, they're going to turn into gas. And that's why you start swelling up twice your size. But since you don't have oxygen in your lungs to feed your brain, you're not going to comprehend that. You're just going to pass out in 15 seconds. And that might be a relief, because after 90 seconds, unless someone rescues you, you're pretty much going to die from asphyxiation. If you cry in outer space, since there's no gravity, your tears, they're not going to fall down your cheeks. Instead, they'll just hover around your eyes. And if you keep crying, the tears will accumulate and grow into a watery glob. But if you're really bawling, well then, that tear glob is going to just become larger and larger until it covers your eyes and crosses over your nose bridge, and then it'll likely connect with the teary glob on the other eye. It's going to be like a wobbling goggle. And at that point, just look at the mirror. That'll cheer you up. Let's say you fall inside a black hole and your friend's outside watching you. And let's assume environmental factors aren't an issue. Well, you're going to be able to look out of the black hole and see your friend. But from your friend's perspective, you're going to appear to move slower and slower. And the reason is, time is slowing down for you inside the black hole. And when you cross the event horizon, which is the point of no return, if you flash your light toward your friend, that light will just bend toward the center with you. And all your friend's going to see is you freezing in time and space. So you probably think that the International Space Station is floating in space, but actually, it's constantly free falling. The thing is, the space station is only 250 miles above the Earth. And at that altitude, gravity is 90% as strong as it is on the Earth's surface. It's still very strong, and that's why the space station is literally falling down. But it never crashes to the ground. The reason is, the Earth is rotating counterclockwise, and the ISS is orbiting in the same direction, but the space station outpaces the Earth. So in a 24-hour period, the Earth is doing one full rotation, but in that same period of time, the space station is actually orbiting the Earth about 16 times. It's traveling so fast that the Earth's surface curves away from the station, and that's why it misses the Earth. If you scale down our solar system proportionally, and let's say the Sun were to be the size of a bowling ball, well, relatively speaking, Mercury would be a pinhead. And Venus and Earth, they'd be like peppercorns. Mars would be another pinhead. Jupiter would be a chestnut. Saturn would be an acorn, and Uranus and Neptune would just be coffee beans. If you scale down our solar system to fit a US map, and let's say the Sun is a bit over half a mile in the center of New York City, well, that means Neptune would be located in Los Angeles, and Mercury would be in Stamford, Connecticut, Venus in New Haven, Earth would be in Philadelphia, and Mars in Hershey, Pennsylvania. And we're talking Saturn in Nashville, Jupiter in Norfolk, Virginia, and Uranus would be in Austin, Texas.